Hello students, now we will discuss another different types of or further divisions of operating systems. So in your previous classes we have learned five categories of operating system. So we have learned different types of operating system. Till now, what we have learnt? First, batch operating system, where similar tasks are grouped together and simultaneously they are being processed with this operating system. Another one is your multi-programming operating system. In this multi-programming operating system, multiple programs simultaneously can be executed by a processor or number of processor or in CPU. Then multi-processing operating system, where number of processors can process a single program or number of different types of program. Then real-time operating system, where results or output of the serial operating system is an instance, very fast, immediate, it provides immediate result at the time of execution, instant result, immediate result. And last one is your time sharing operating system. So these five different types of operating system we have learnt in our previous classes. Batch operating system, what happens? Similar jobs are formed by group. Similar task, similar requirement forms a group, means group execution. That is the batch, means group. Simultaneously, similar jobs were executed. In case of multi-programming, multiple programs, several programs were executed simultaneously. Okay, means it is also multitasking. Multiple programs can perform multiple tasks. So this operating system provides a multi-programming environment. Several tasks, several programs can be executed simultaneously or concurrent execution of number of programs. That is the multi-programming operating system. Next one is multi-processing. So if a CPU, a memory of the computer possesses a single processor, it will take much more time. So to avoid these difficulties, this time delay, we can use number of processors in memory, and all processors can simultaneously process a single task or multiple task also. Then real time provides always immediate result. It provides always immediate result, instant result, instant output, at same time very time small time interval. Means it throughput is very very fast here. So immediate result, we are getting immediate result, instant result from this real-time operating system. Then time sharing operating system, where CPU time are shared among a number of processors in the memory. So these five different types of operating system, as per our syllabus, we have covered, we have studied in details. So if there is any doubt, you can ask me. Now today we will discuss another types of or further divisions of operating systems, like distributed operating system. You should have the knowledge of this operating system. It is just like an ordinary operating system, but runs on a multiple independent CPU. So this operating system has or execute runs program in multiple CPU or multiple independent CPU. Multiple independent CPU. Multiple independent CPU or more than one CPU can execute for this distributed operating system. Means it is distributed. Just to find the meaning of distributed. Means it is shareable. Okay. So multiple independent CPU. Independent CPU, so CPU are not dependent, autonomous systems, independent CPU, independently that CPU can execute the program. So multiple independent CPUs are used in case of this distributed operating system. So the key concept of this operating system is transparency. So why we are using this distributed operating system? Okay, so this distributed operating system help to the key concept is transparency. This is the key concept of this distributed operating system, which everyone will know. This is the transparency and the virtual uniprocessor and virtual uniprocessor. Virtual uniprocessor means uni means one processor. It seems as if all are using a single processor. It seems as if all are using, all programs, all CPU are using a single processor, that is a virtual uniprocessor. But there are no number of processors there. But they are working in such a way that programmer or user can think that it is a single processor. But exactly, this is not a single processor. Okay. So users are not aware of where the programs are being run, and where their files are residing. User is not aware. User don't know where the program is resided or where the programs are in executed or in run. The files are residing. All are handled automatically and efficiently by this operating system. So all the things, user is not aware where the file is residing or where the execution or program is running. It is not aware, but operating system automatically provides all this facilities. Okay, so distributed operating system is a collection of autonomous computer system. Also, you can tell that it's a collections of autonomous computers. The computer system. What do you mean autonomous? Because the system having with a own processing capability. The system is having own processing capability, that is the autonomous computers. So it is a collection of autonomous computers, or there are a number of multiple independent CPUs. So autonomous computers may have independent CPU. Okay. So this is the distributed operating system. So the distributed operating system, it governs the operation of a distributed computer system and provides a virtual machine abstraction. It provides a virtual machine abstraction. Same thing I have written here. Virtual abstraction. Okay. So virtual machine abstraction. Virtual machine abstraction. Same thing. So all it seems as if all programs are being executed in a single processor that processes all the things. But exactly that is not single. There are number of processors, and these processors are in different computers also. So there are different computers number of processors. So all are independent, but their execution in this execution manner is such way that all will be seen as if they are working in a single computer. That is the virtual machine abstraction. Okay. So the key objective of distribution operating system is your transparency. Okay. This is transparency. And distributed operating system provides a system where it is sharing of resources. So it provides resource sharing. Okay. It provides resource sharing. System wide sharing of resources. You can call system by sharing of resources. So every resource can be shareable. Every resource can be used by several systems. Okay, this like computational capacity, file and input output devices. So all devices are system wise sharing. Means if a system, if a output device, if a input device of a computer can be used by another system. Means input output devices of a system can be used by another system as a system wide sharing of resources. Okay. These systems facilitate access to several resources communications with the remote process and distribution of a computation. So it is also remote processing. It uses a remote process. It will be controlled by a remote control, you can call remote processing. Remote process so that the resource communication can be possible. Means several resources can be communicable. Okay. So this is the distribution of a computation. All these points are for distributed operating system. Example I can give you, novel operating system. Example of this distributed operating system is your novel network. Okay. So though this distributed operating system not included in the syllabus, but you have to give brief knowledge about the distributed operating system. So important concept is there are number of computers, or there are number of autonomous computers, they are processing as a single one. Means number of independent process CPUs are working as if they are one, but there are several independent CPUs. And important objective for this distributed operating system is transparency, because everything is shareable, everything can be shared. Means here the system wise sharing is possible. Any resources, any input or output devices, any memory is shareable among several computers. So, and the collections of autonomous computers, these are the example of novel networks. So this is the distributed operating system. Okay. Clear? If you will doubt, you can ask me. Now, further computers, further computer operating system can be divided as PC operating system, PC operating system. Further, you know, operating system can be divided as PC operating system. One by one, we will just briefly describe. So, in the PC operating system, the operating system used in personal computer. Okay, so one by one we will discuss very briefly. So, PC operating system, server operating system. Server operating system, mainframe operating system, mobile operating system, handheld further operating system can be divided according to their use. So operating system used in personal computer, that is the PC operating system. So normally you are using those operating system, DOS, Windows, Linux, means PC, that is the PC operating system. Okay. So this operating system works in personal computer. Okay. So PCs are the microcomputer, which has a microprocessor. Normally, what is a PC? I will explain one by one. But the operating system used in server, server is a powerful machine which can control number of microcomputers connected with it. So the operating system working in the server, that is the server operating system. Then mainframe. So mainframe is a powerful than microcomputer. So the operating system uses, operating system used by the mainframe computer, we can call that the mainframe operating system. Okay. Then mobile operating system. So any not stationary devices, those are mobile, they are not stationary, not fixed. So that is the mobile, our handset, our mobile or smart device is also one type of mobile. So operating system used in this type of device, that is the mobile operating system. And the handheld operating system almost is the same. Those are the handheld, means your palm top. So our smartphone is also one type of palm top. So the operating systems use this type of devices at the handheld operating system. So overall, we'll discuss one by one. First, let us discuss about the PC operating system. Okay. PC operating system. So PC is the personal computer. So normally personal computer have the microcomputers. Normally personal computer and microcomputers, because there is a microprocessor in its memory, in its CPU. Okay. So the video and a detachable keyboard. It has a microprocessor, the PC has a microprocessor, it has a microprocessor and detachable keyboard. Okay. And a keyboard. So the operating system helps, microprocessor is attached with some input output devices. So the operating system helps to manage, to control those input output devices are connected to this microprocessor. Okay. Example, MS-DOS. Example, MS-DOS. Microsoft Disk Operating System, MS-Windows. और लिनक्स और यूनिक्स ऑल आर यूज इन ए कंप्यूटर सिस्टम दैट इज द पीसी ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम वेयर द पॉइंटिंग डिवाइस कैन बी यूज पॉइंटिंग डिवाइस लाइक माउस माउस कैन बी यूज ओके एंड ऑल्सो कीबोर्ड कैन बी यूज सो दिस ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम सपोर्ट्स ऑल दिस इनपुट आउटपुट devices okay so nowadays the widely used operating system to connect personal work station window NT IBM OS 2 Macintosh OS 2 all are the examples for this PC operating system okay so very briefly I can elaborate I will give the description for this one very small description so this is the PC operating system okay now let us see another type of operating system that is the server operating system. So, what is a server? So, the operating system used in server, that is the server operating system. So, what is the server? Server is a powerful computer that controls many number of client computers. It is a powerful computer that controls many number of microcomputers. Okay, that controls many numbers of client computers. Means a server computer can control number of client computers. That's the server. Okay. File server, example, file server, your network server, database server, print server, web server, mail server, application server, there are so many types of servers are working. Okay. So the operating system used in the server, that is server operating system. Okay. So this operating system is designed to be installed and used in server computers. So these operating systems are used in server computer. The server is also a computer. So this operating system is installed in server computer. Okay. So by this server computer, all other computers are communicated with each other. Server communicates number of microcomputers, number of other computers also. Okay. So this operating system are also used for engineering designing, order processing, and the payroll calculations. So the use of this operating system is used very multiple processes or it is engineering design, order processing, payroll system, salary slip. We can use salary slip for this. So that is the server. You think what server does? The banking sector, server is working. Everywhere you will find there is a server. Server controls all client computers. So this operating system supports to be work in server. That is server operating system. So server operating system is a suitable feature for client-server architecture. Basic concept of this is, this operating system is client-server architecture. Client-server architecture. So one client computer, one server computers can control the number of client computers. So the architecture for this server of operating system is the client server architecture means this operating system can be used within a server. Okay. So the server operating system ability to access server in both GUI and CLI. It uses GUI graphic user interface by using mouse or pointing device. That is the graphic user interface. No need to remember the commands. Another is the CLI command line interface. Here we can use the commands. Here you use the commands just like your DOS, MS DOS, we are using some commands. By putting commands, we can execute all the things. These commands are used in operating system. Okay. So this is the server operating system. It provides control interface to manage users, employment, security, and other administrative processes. So normally it basically helps in administrative this is all about the server operating system. Okay, this is the server operating system. Next one. Next one is your what is the example for the server operating system? I will tell you the examples of a server operating system: Red Hat, Enterprise, Linux. Example: OS 2. The example of OS 2. This is server operating system. Mac OS. This is another example of server operating system. Okay, Windows NT. Windows NT is also another network operating system. So these are the examples of server operating system. Okay, so very briefly I will give the description for this concept. Okay, next one. Mainframe operating system. Mainframe. So there are so many types of computer. Mainframe computer is one of them. So the operating system used in mainframe computer, that is the mainframe operating system. Mainframe operating computer is such a computer that controls 100 different type of autonomous microcomputers. So this mainframe operating system is designed to make the best various resource utilization. It ensures maximum amount of work processed and efficiently. So the mainframe computers as a powerful computer and this operating system provides maximum resource utilization, processed efficiently. So it processes most efficient processing. So here the processing is a very fast and efficient in mainframe computer system. So the mainframe environment, the system software, the hardware comprises a highly advanced computer architecture. You can call it is a highly advanced computer architecture. Okay, highly advanced computer architecture. This is for mainframe computer. The most commercial, large commercial organization are using mainframe. So the operating system used in this mainframe computers. Okay, so this operating system developed by the computer manufacturer. They have their own operating system. Normally, mainframe computers, the operating systems for the mainframe computers are developed by the manufacturer. Okay, manufacturer also provides this type of operating system with this system. So this operating system has better processing facility and security. It has better processing facilities and security also. Better security. And the mainframe computers might run multiple operating systems like ZOS, ZVM. Example for this mainframe computer system is your Linux also. Linux can be used in mainframe computers. ZOS computer can be also used in mainframe computer, and ZVM also. So these type of operating systems are the mainframe operating systems. So in this way you can derive mainframe operating system, server operating system, PC operating system, different mobile operating systems. Nowadays we are using mobile and smartphone operating systems like Apple's iPhone operating system, Google's Android operating system, Nokia's Symbian operating system, Microsoft Windows operating system, Samsung's Beta operating system. So normally a smartphone we are using so many operating systems, and there are also mobile operating system, and also there are some handheld operating system. Those devices are can be called by either ham or palm top. Smartphone is also one type of a palm top. So the operating system used in this type of handheld device, that is the handheld operating system. So this operating system is a small keyboard. It can be a small touchable sensitive screen, which is used for a handheld operating system. We can use screen touch, means we can sensitive screen and also small keyboard for this operating system. Example, Windows C. Okay, so you can write, you can know the handheld operating system and also mobile operating system. So in this way, we can further divide the operating system in our day-to-day life. Okay, so follow all these things very briefly, and it will help in your exam. If you have a doubt, you can ask me, you can query me with the WhatsApp, with my WhatsApp number. Okay, thank you for watching all this video. Okay, thank you.